हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ मलेरिया विच इज़ अ प्रोटोजोवन डिजीज़। सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द मलेरिया, इट हैज़ बीन फॉर द थाउजेंड्स ऑफ ईयर अ वेरी सीरियस डिजीज़ फॉर द ट्रॉपिकल एंड टेम्परेट रीजन्स। इट वॉज ऑलमोस्ट एलिमिनेटेड अ फ्यू ईयर्स बैक विद द एफर्ट्स ऑफ वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड आउट नेशन malaria eradication program, but unfortunately it has appeared again. So as you can see, this is a electron microscopic view of the plasmodium, which is the causal organism in its gametophytic phase in the RBCs of the human blood. So let's talk about the symptoms of the malaria. The attack of malaria is preceded by yawning, tiredness, headache and muscular pain. During the fever, the patient feels chilly and shivers and has acute headache, nausea and high temperatures. After a few hours, the body perspires freely and the temperature becomes normal. The cycle is repeated if no medicine is taken. Blood smear made during fever shows the malarial parasites. No parasites are seen at other times. In chronic cases, there is general weakness and anemia due to large-scale destruction of red blood corpuscles. This is also accompanied by the enlargement of spleen and liver. So let's see and talk about the causal organism, that is Plasmodium, which is a protozoan, and it while we classify it, it comes under the kingdom Protozoa. So malaria is basically caused by the toxins produced in the human body by the malarial parasite named as Plasmodium. Plasmodium is a tiny protozoan responsible for malaria. The different species which are mentioned in your book for Plasmodium are basically of three types. The first one is Plasmodium vivax. It causes benign tertian malaria, which attacks every third day, that is after 48 hours. Recurrent attacks of fever are called paroxysms. The fever is mild and seldom fatal. This species is widespread in tropical and temperate regions, including India. The next species is Plasmodium malariae. It causes quartan malaria, which recurs every fourth day, that is after 72 hours. This species is found in both tropical and temperate regions, but it is not very common. The third one is Plasmodium falciparum. It alone is capable of causing three types of malaria. That's why it is also known as Cutidan malaria, which attacks almost daily. Malignant tertian malaria, which recurs every 48 hours, but is very severe and often fatal. And irregular malaria, this species found only in tropical regions. The incubation period for the malaria caused by Plasmodium vivax is about 10 to 14 days. So before starting the life cycle of the Plasmodium, let's have a review of the history of the malaria. The name malaria was given by Malo in 1872 on the belief that it was caused by foul air of the marshy localities. See, the life cycle of Plasmodium, it includes the pathogen, which is basically a Plasmodium. The host organism is human being. Vector organism is female Anopheles mosquito. Malarial parasite requires two hosts, human and mosquitoes, to complete its life cycle. The female Anopheles mosquito is the vector which transmits the disease. The life cycle of Plasmodium is subdivided into three stages: a phase of growth and asexual multiplication, which occurring in man is known as cyzogyny. Sexual phase or gamo गोनी विच स्टार्ट्स इन द मैन एंड इज कम्प्लीटेड इन द मॉस्किटो एंड एन एसेक्सुअल मल्टीप्लीकेटिव फेज टर्म स्पोरोगोनी इन द मॉस्किटो. लेट्स चेक द इंफॉर्मेशन. सी एज सून एज द स्पोरोजॉइड्स विच आर बींग transmitted by the bite of the mosquito, they enters inside the human body. They reaches through the liver cells, those which are basically the simple type of cells, epithelial cells. Okay, so when the sporozoids they reach the liver cells through blood streams, most of the sporozoids they start dividing themselves by the process of mitosis. So after mitotic division, their number can exceed up to 1000 or approximately it's equal to 1024. So these small entities which are formed inside the liver cell, they ultimately ruptures the liver cell, and the cytoplasm which are the merozoids, they enter to further infect the blood cells. Inside the red blood corpuscle cells, these merozoids they divide and ultimately they form the amoeboid stage. Then at this stage they are known as hemozoid particles, which because they are present in the red blood corpuscle cells. Ultimately, after their further division in the red blood cells and increasing their numbers, they ruptures the RBC, and the merozoid they releases from the red blood corpuscle cells. Ultimately, they further infect the RBCs. Now, till this stage, the whole process which occurred inside the human body, in this stage the plasmodium it was in its asexual mode of reproduction. Afterwards, when the human being, which is the host organism, the infected human being, when its blood is being sucked by the human vector, that is mosquito, that is female anopheles mosquito, when it sucks the blood of the infected person, it takes the merozoids in this condition, which are basically the gametocytes of male and female. Now which is acting as a blood meal for the female anopheles. Inside the mosquito's body, these gametocytes they form their gametes, and they further fertilize to form the zygote. These zygotes they further develop into the sporozoids, which are then introduced into the body of human beings by the bite of the female anopheles mosquito. Now I have given this, see, you can see the sporozoid stage of the Plasmodium falciparum, in which the sporozoids they are basically sickle celled. They are shown at the resolution of 10 micrometer. So this is electron microscopic view of the Plasmodium falciparum. Now I have, for the convenience of you student, divided the different stages of Plasmodium and the site of Plasmodium, because most of the questions which are coming in the board examinations, they are asking where are the sporozoids and what was the mode of or nature of the reproductive stages, that is whether they are asexual, sexual, and site of location in the either it is present in human being or mosquito. So you can easily see this information. एंड मेमोराइज इट. सो लेट्स आई हैव ऑल्सो एड वन ऑफ द लाइफ साइकिल रिलेटेड पिक्चर हियर विच इज़ ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर टू द डायग्राम गिवन इन द NCERT बुक. सी वेन एवर द मॉस्किटो द इट बाइट्स द ह्यूमन बींग दैट इज़ द हेल्दी ह्यूमन बींग स्पोरोजॉइड दे आर बींग इंट्रोड्यूस्ड थ्रू द ब्लड स्ट्रीम एंड दे अल्टीमेटली रीचेज द लिवर सेल्स वेयर दे डिवाइड एंड फॉर्म द मेरोजाइट. देन दीज साइकल्स आर बींग कम्प्लीटेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ साइजोगाइनी एंड ड्यूरिंग दिस फेज वेन दे इन्फेक्ट द ब्लड सेल्स दैट इज RBCs where the gametocytes they are being formed and when this blood which contains the gametocyte is being taken up by the mosquito ultimately the reproduction it occurs in the abdomen of the female and finally these zygotes these gametes they fertilize. Here you can see the fertilization process. They ultimately form a zygote, then oocinate is being formed and these oocytes they ultimately reaches into the midgut of the female mosquito in the form of sporozoids and ultimately when this mosquito when it sucks the blood from the healthy individual in that process this mosquito it also delivers the sporozoite into the healthy human being. So this is how the two intermediate hosts are being acting as the intermediates for the life cycle of this mosquito. Now let's see what are the CBSE based questions for the different years. So these are the questions which basically includes the 3 marks questions. So one is how and at what stages does plasmodium enter into a human body. Next is with the help of flow chart show the stages of asexual reproduction in the life cycle of parasite in the infected humans. Why does the victim show symptoms of high fever? Next is this question was asked in the year 2008. Name the respective forms in which the malaria parasite gain the entry into the human body and of the female anopheles. So you can easily check this information through this table and answer it very easily. Now name the host where sexual and asexual reproduction of the malarial parasite occurs respectively. You can easily answer this question after this whole discussion. Name the toxin responsible for the appearance of the symptoms of the malaria in the human. Why do the symptoms occur periodically? Because these are the actually when the merozoites they destroy the RBCs, the chills and the body shivers and this recurrence will occur after a certain period of time. This is the basic reason for this. The next question is give the scientific name of the parasite that causes malignant malaria in human beings. The third form which is mentioned in this slide is the responsible organism, type of species. At what stage does this parasite enter into the human body? So you can easily identify through the cycle at what stage it enters inside the human body. What do its sporozoid, what do the symptoms of why do the symptoms of malaria not appear immediately after the entry of sporozoids into the human body? Because they have incubation period also. Give the scientific name of the malaria parasite that causes malignant malaria in human beings. You know the answer for this question. Next is for 5 number also. CBSE has asked this question in 2013. So what was the question? It was describe the asexual and sexual phases of life cycle of plasmodium that causes malaria in human beings. So there you need to draw the entire life cycle along with the explanation. In which parts of the body of the host do the following events in the life cycle of the plasmodium takes place? Name both the body parts and the host. Fertilization, development of the gametocytes, release of the sporozoite, asexual reproduction. So this can be easily answered to you. बाय यू. ओके, थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स.